Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today we will study about the restricted earthfall protection. So what is restricted earthfall protection and how restricted earthfall protection work, schematic diagram and then measurement and practical from the relay. Right. So restricted earthfall protection scheme is used to protect the system from any fault in the transformer winding, right, or to isolate the transformer winding where fault occurs from the system. So here this is the scheme. For example, this is the HV side of the transformer and this is LV side, right. So for example, this is delta or star. So this section will not be considered in the REF protection. Sometimes it is also called half differential protection because it only consider the LV side of the transformer, or for example if it is connected to LV side it will consider only LV winding, or if it is the scheme is connected for HV side it will consider HV only. So that's why sometimes it is called half differential protection, right. So how this scheme works, for example we have one delta star transformer. And this is the LV side of the transformer. So R yellow blue phase having a separate CT connected to this. And similarly, we have one CT connected to neutral after this, which is earthed, right? So in normal condition, as we know that there will be balanced flow of current. So due to balanced flow of current, this I1 and I2, this both will be equal to zero. How? No. First normal condition. Normal case, summation of current across this restricted earth fault relay IREF will be equal to zero because I1 equal to 0, I2 equal to 0. So this is clear for us that how I2 in normal condition will be 0 because there will be no flow of current in the neutral, right? This is the neutral. There will be no flow of current in the neutral during normal condition. And this one also be equal to 0. Why this will be equal to 0? Because this I1 is the summation of I1. Is the summation of IR plus IY plus IB, where IR is a vector. It will be equal to IR magnitude at an angle of 0 degree plus IY at an angle of 120 degree plus IB magnitude at an angle of 240 degree. Now in the normal case, IR magnitude will be equal to IY magnitude, it will be equal to IB magnitude. For example, we consider this 0.5 ampere. So after putting this value, point 5 at an angle of 120 degree, right, when you calculate this value by means of calculator, this will be equal to zero. So I1 will be equal to 0 in normal case. But for example, any fault happens near the neutral, here any region under this CT is mainly concerned with the transformer's winding, right? So any fault happens here in this region, it will consider. So in faulty condition, we know that the magnitude will vary. In any phase, magnitude will vary plus angle will also be reversed, because the current will flow the easiest path, which is the faulty side. So this equation will become imbalance. Now, faulty case. Faulty case or faulty condition. The summation of I REF will not be equal to zero, which means that I1 will not be equal to zero, it will carry some value, and same I2 will not be equal to zero. So when both this current flows through the relay, which we show you on the previous sheet, this will be add up I1, I2, addition will occur, and this going to I, this is REF relay, and due to this summation it will have some sitting value. For example, in our case, which we will show you in the during injection time, setting value for REF trip R I summation of I REF, this will be equal to 0.5, right? 0.5 ampere. So when we inject this and this summation become 0.5 ampere, the relay will be picked and the trip will occur. Now we will show you this condition practically from the relay. Now we have a 100 ohm resistor which is inside the panel. Okay, now by using Ohm law V equal to IR, so set value for ampere is 0.5 ampere, right? Which I'll show you from here. See, IREF 500 milliampere. IREF, right? So by this way, if you calculate, we should inject 50 volt to make pickup for the trip. So now I will make it on, and slowly and gradually we will inject 50 volts. At the same time, you can see the milliamperes on the relay. When this pickup is reached, it will make the trip. Now voltage is 46 volts. I will slowly increase. 49, now 50 volts there, 481. Now pickup is reached, so REF trip. Now here see the voltage, this 52.2 volts. So the trip occur for 52.2. Here is the formula which I explained you, V equal to IR. So here our resistor in this circuit is 100 ohm. We adjust this 100 ohm.
and set current I show you 0.5 ampere, 500 milliampere. So by this way we will calculate V, which is equal to 50 volt. So by injecting 50 volt we will get the setup value for REF trip. Now we will start injection by means of current. Now
no.
we
close.